like, don't make sense to really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken. That tasty finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep it racking my socks. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey. Hey, yo. Nike check.
Since way back in 1973, there's a look at Bills Stadium just outside of Buffalo, New York. The folks in Buffalo love their Bills, and a moment ago they entered to the delight of this sold-out crowd. They're set for football as their Bills will do battle with the Los Angeles Chargers. And we are underway in Buffalo. Taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Into the hands of Huntley. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. A little glimpse of his athleticism there and what they're going to have to deal with. He can use his legs to dance around back behind the line of scrimmage and beyond the line of scrimmage.
And wouldn't you love to get a copy of their defensive scouting report going into the week? Because that's been stressed the whole time. Keep him bottled up. Keep him in the pocket. But it's the first drive of the game and emotions are running high. Someone forgot that, trying to make a big play and gave up a bigger one instead.
Second and 10, a very chilly day here, but no snow. And I got to say, if it's going to be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jahleel Adai.
Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football, but at the same time, you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there. Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10 at the 41-yard line. They'll start with the option. That one good for 10 yards, and it'll be second and very short.
All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has three options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football off a triple option, you've actually called that play.
Brings up third down.
They'll try to pick up the first with Eckler. Pass the 20. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. A stop there on third. They could have held him to three on this opening drive. Now they have to bow their necks on first and goal.
And if I'm looking at this from the offense's point of view, that's a big-time pickup right there, and I'd go right at them with another momentum play. I'd go quickly and attack them, because right now, they probably have their heads down a little.
And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Justin Herbert, a four-yard touchdown scamper. And the Chargers have taken a first-quarter lead.
Nice job of polishing off that drive, but all the credit there goes to that play prior.
Yeah, it certainly does, because after that big play, I think resistance almost felt futile at that point, didn't it? And the very next play, they come right back, quick, fast, and in a hurry, and put it in the end zone.
And Roberts choosing not to bring this one out.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3.
Brings up 2nd and 3.
So the shotgun snap to Allen. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up 3rd down.
And 3 yards to go.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3.
56, Mike, 56, right there.
Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. He completes it to the tight end, Knox. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Allen and Knox teaming up there for Buffalo first down. From the gun, it's Allen. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
The last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line.
Melvin Ingram. Make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down.
A run with Huntley.
9 yards on the gain there, so he got half of it back. And it'll be third down.
At the 30-yard line. It's a gain of 9. Makes it 3rd and 9.
Operating from the gun, Allen. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 15-yard line. Allen to Diggs there for a Buffalo first.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Operating from the red zone now, Allen. That's complete. It's Jason Huntley. He's down inside the 10 to the 8. And it comes on a gain of 8. A gain of 8 there on the 8th play of the drive.
At the 8-yard line.
This a quick pass to Davis. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Gabriel Davis with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game.
Good bounce back drive right there through the pick on drive number 1. Drive number 2 leads them right down the field into the end zone.
Agree totally. Excellent bounce back, tremendous poise, confidence never lost. And obviously he transmitted that to his teammates as well. What a really nice drive.
Extra point right down the middle. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
25-yard line.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Herbert and the Chargers now with a 1st and 10
at their 25-yard line.
From the gun, he'll set up to throw.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up 2nd down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
They run the option on 2nd down.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. 12 yards there and a 1st down.
A gain of 12.
And here is Eckler. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5 to about the 39.
Well, sometimes as a running back, you've got to be able to improvise when the hole's not where you expect it to be. But in this case, there wasn't any improvisation that he could do that was going to work. Kind of like if you're trying to be a comedian on open mic night at the improv and you run into a tough crowd.
Finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. And he's got a 1st down as a tackle made at the Bills' 40.
7-7.
Herbert. And he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49. Ed Oliver. He's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. So now 20 yards to go on 2nd down after the sack. Work to be done.
Off the play fake to Eckler. It's Herbert.
And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to 3rd down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on 1st down. They didn't get all of it back. But now they look at 3rd down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
from the gun. Herbert on third down. The Buffalo defense does its job, and it's fourth down.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
Field goal gets them closer, but they say no thanks. We want the lead. They snap it to Herbert. He's got his man here. It's Green. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on fourth. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. Shaquille Barrett in on the tackle. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. A shotgun snap for Herbert. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. For a second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. And that'll be incomplete.
He certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. Play fake, and now Herbert to throw. And that's going to be caught. Oh, a one-handed grab there. He's got it for the touchdown.
Touchdown.
I'll let you do the analysis, partner, but with every touchdown pass this young quarterback throws and with the success that his team has had, I just continue to be more and more impressed.
Let's both do the analysis. Impressed. Aren't we both?
Yeah.
I mean, and why shouldn't we be? We've seen him improve throughout the year. We've seen him settle in now, and you can see the confidence of the team has grown. His confidence has grown. I think that everyone around this guy feels good about what they've seen, and it's also safe for him when he's driving home to turn on Sports Talk Radio. He's okay.
Andre Roberts now to return it. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
The Bills take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And you know, certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good, and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys, get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, and I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
This throw caught left side, and he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. That one a gain of 20 and a first down.
At the 45-yard line.
The gun, Allen.
it's Knox, the tight end, making the catch.
Allen's pass.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
A gain of 5 brings up second and 5 at the Chargers' 40-yard line.
Now Allen again, eluding the pressure right. Now he'll pull it down. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Josh Allen, very athletic at 6'5", showing the versatility, picking up the first on the scramble. To his receiver McKenzie, and he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 13 and a Buffalo first down. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. First down, Huntley. Kenneth Murray, the linebacker, there to make the play defensively.
And that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, and they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
Throwing on second and 8, Allen. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jahleel Adai. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting 3. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
The Charger drive about to get going. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of 6s. Back-to-back, what a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a 2-for-1 without ever even giving up the football. On second down, here's Herbert. It's Williams. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Operating from the gun, Herbert. He'll get this to Eckler. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Herbert going to try and run. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number 1. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's 1st and 10. Herbert operating from the red zone. Allen has it left side. And able to get this down inside the 15 to either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, 2nd down.
It's a pickup of 3. Brings up 2nd and 7.
Herbert off of play action. Sliding out of the pocket. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up 3rd down.
And 7 yards to go.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. They go back to the ground now with Eckler. And they're able to corral him right around the 8, and that's short of the first down. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll bring up a fourth down. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. So on fourth down, on comes the Charger kicker, Michael Badgley. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Badgley able to punch this one through. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. Still a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they do get 3 before the half and expand that lead.
And they have to be happy about that. And we haven't met a team yet that doesn't put an emphasis on trying to get points on the board in the last 2 minutes of a half. They'll be real excited to have those up on the board.
And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Come to the line to start their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he...
And Allen going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked off by Casey Hayward. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
At their own 32-yard line.
Final play of the first half, barring a penalty, as they come up on first and 10. On the option, here's Eckler. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Charger drive about to get going. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. From the gun, Herbert flushed out right. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Well, we know he has pretty good hands on display there. In fact, he only needed one of them.
Yeah, nowadays, all these receivers work on this, right? They do the one-handed catches off the machine in practice. They do it with their quarterbacks. They do it contested, uncontested. They make it part of their repertoire.
On first down, Justin Herbert. He gets it left side to Johnson. So the contact came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body control, and they can fake you out. In this case, as you described, got there before the ball got to the receiver. Penalty flag had to come out.
They run the option here on first and 10. And he's going to be met at about the 43. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down,
That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
And Herbert able to get this one to Eckler out of the backfield.
He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. A gain there of 21 yards.
And the Chargers first down.
Herbert setting up to throw on first down. On the screen, this is Eckler. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. A completion, yes, but certainly not what they wanted. A loss of a full 6 yards. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Operating from the gun, Herbert, and this is going to be incomplete.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield. They had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it up to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Herbert back to the air. And that is incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
A 45-yard attempt.
And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And that will open the lead up now to 20-7. So put another 3 on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out.
And all deep in his own territory, coughs up the football. And picked up by the Chargers.
There's never a good place on the field to fumble the ball. Let's just call it as it is.
But definitely not your own red zone.
In your own red zone, it's heightened, isn't it? Because you're almost automatically giving up a score and the momentum, and everything just changes for your team.
Yeah, so the kickoff fumble now, great field position. Running on first down, Eckler. He's going to get 4 out of this as he's down to the 10-yard line.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
At the 10-yard line.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. And this is complete. It's Allen. And he's in for a Charger touchdown.
Touchdown.
Keenan Allen. His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Chargers are going to add on to their lead.
All the receivers in the league are plenty good enough. Otherwise, they wouldn't make it in the NFL. But the ones that go to the Pro Bowl, they have refined route running ability.
Now the Charger offense will stay on the field as they'll line up to go for the 2-point try. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up 2 more.
Makes the score Chargers 28, Bills 7. Mike Badgley to kick off for the Chargers.
Following the touchdown, Badgley out there to kick it away. Here's the all-pro returner from 2018, Andre Roberts. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
Take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership.
At the 48-yard line.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. They'll run it here with Huntley. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
The tackle made just shy of midfield. A gain of a yard. Brings up second.
So the shotgun snap to Allen. Flush to his right. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat. And if he flushes out, they're fine with that. And they force another incompletion.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Check him out. He's going to sit right over the middle. Watch the middle. Single, single. Middle. Lots 49. Lots 49.
To throw, it's Allen. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 10 yards, good enough for a Buffalo first down. Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. Over the middle, complete. That's McKenzie. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 10 more for him on that one. He's been a busy man. It's a first down. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3.
That's
a really good pickup of 28 yards. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Jason Huntley, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Bills get a bit closer.
People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that. It wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
The Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. Their lead down from 21 to 14, but still sitting at a great spot. Up 2 scores here in the third quarter. The throw right side is complete here on the first play of the drive. And they finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 34.
41-yard gain.
A big play there for L.A. 41 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Different story this time around. We had that huge gain followed by a sizable loss here. Coming up now on a 2nd and 15 following that sack. Oh,
Off the play fake to Eckler, it's Herbert.
And he whips that one incomplete there. They were looking for Johnson that time. And that'll make it third down.
Looked like he had a couple of different options as far as who to throw to on that play. And who am I to say this, but I'm not sure he made the right decision.
Well, the window of opportunity is always going to be small in the NFL. That's why those quarterbacks who make quick decisions and have quick releases have the most success in this league.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Out of the gun, Herbert. He's going to fire one deep left sideline, and that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. A bad time for a roughing penalty, and they get the gift of a first and 10. He'll keep it himself. They'll run out of the gun with Eckler. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
A gain of 13 yards. First down, Los Angeles.
Back now in Buffalo. It's Charger football, and they've got the lead as well as we begin the fourth quarter. Now a first and 10 at the 11. From the gun, Herbert. Dancing to his left. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. He lost the football. Now this is picked up by the Bills. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Partner, that one looked like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, two-score game. So hold on here, not done in the fourth. Here's Allen following the fumble recovery. He's got it complete to Diggs, right side. And this is going to double their room to maneuver, able to get it from the 5 to the 10-yard line.
Brings up second and 5. At the 10.
To throw again on second down. Allen finding Knox there, complete. And brought down, but not before reaching the 25. Charles, this one, not over, certainly, but you set the magic number earlier in this game at 20 points, said that they would need to hold them right around that marker under it. And what are you seeing here?
Well, that number is still in play because we said, okay, 20 or under gives them a chance to win. Right on pace for being in that range, and guess what? They've got a shot.
Allen now on first down.
And he'll get this into the hands of Huntley.
And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 10 more there and another first down.
You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
On first down, Allen. He's going to air one out. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit. Even for those big tight ends, who you would think could absorb that contact.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. To throw again, Allen. And he'll flip this out to Huntley. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. That'll leave them with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Now on third and 2, they're going to elect to throw with Allen. He gets it to Brown. Complete. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. Allen finding Brown for a Bills first down.
50-yard line.
Field. Here's Allen. Buying time to his left. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Cole Beasley, the intended target. That'll bring up second down.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
49 to Mike. 56. He's coming. Double up. He's coming.
Throwing again. Allen escaping the pressure right. That's complete to Davis. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who could turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
The Bills on third down. A perfect 4 for 4 thus far. This will be third and 5. Again, they'll throw with Allen. Forced out to his left. And he took the contact as he was throwing it. And the ball drops incomplete.
We just saw another example of really good defensive football, which has led to the cushion that they have in this game. Got to him once again, knocked him on the ground, forced an incompletion.
Yeah, they've set the tone. It's one thing to set the tone, another to come in here on the road and set the tone.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. One final try here for Allen. He completes it to the tight end, Knox. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Now left side on the swing pass, and he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Not much there, only a yard. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9.
At the 12-yard line.
Allen to throw once more. And that is caught, and he has now tied the record. Touchdown. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
He's got it, and they're back within a touchdown at 28-21.
Makes the score Chargers 28, Bills 21.
This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going.
After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit, and you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you've got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Herbert off of play action. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10.
On second down, here's a keeper by the QB.
He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner, and there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here to have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. They're facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead. A shotgun snap for Herbert. He's got his man. It's Williams.
And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
A Charger first there as Herbert finds Williams. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of a yard brings up second and 11 at the 46-yard line.
You'd have to think likely another running play coming here, second and 11. It's Eckler again. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down.
Throw. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
He only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Here now, Roberts. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10.
At their own 23-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences, and this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Well, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. The former third-round pick, Justin Jones, bringing the lumber that time. Back to throw. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down.
56. Mike, 56. Right there, 56.
The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
We got three. We got three, folks. We got three. Mike's 49. Time, 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 time. I smell fear in that offense. I smell fear in that offense. 49. 49, guys. Mike, Mike, 49. I got you. I got you.
Allen to throw. Flushed out right. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And it looks like the Chargers are going to win this thing.
That's the reason we ball for. Circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
Victory formation, time for the Chargers. They take a knee. So this one's over. It's in the win column for the LA Chargers. And this, not always an easy proposition, Charles. You had a West Coast team that traveled east, but they got the job done.
And there's so much that goes into it, because your body time and your body clock different from what you're used to west, because if you go east, you're going to lose up to 3 hours, right? So is your body going to be awake when it's time to play? A lot of teams actually rehearse it. They practice it. Maybe the week of the game, they move everything up to that time frame so guys get used to doing it that way. I remember when I played at Tennessee, when we had to go from east to west, our trainer Tim Caron said, leave your watches on East Coast time. Every piece of information we got was East Coast Standard Time. Try to psychologically tell us what to do, as well as prepare our bodies the same way.
So for the Chargers, they keep pace in the playoff race as they move to 8-3 on the year. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to New England to take on the Patriots. Meanwhile, for Buffalo, it's a loss that could hurt them come playoff seeding time as they drop to 8-3. And they'll try to get back to their winning ways next week as they head to Santa Clara to take on the 49ers.